Hi guys, I'm gonna give you some of the answers to the "You are more like a dolphin than you think" assignment because I want to make sure you guys got out of it what we would like you to, and you're prepared for the test, which is gonna be this week. So I spread it over 3 days because I want to make sure you have enough time to get it done and you're not like doing a bunch all in one day. So there's 9 stations, so you could have done like 3 per day because it's spread over 3 days. Anyways, here's some of the answers and what I wanted you to learn from these stations. So first here we have a bunch of limbs from different animals. So we have a human arm, a dolphin fin, a turtle arm or leg, I mean, a horse leg, right? And all of them have the same bones. Now, the bones are slightly different sizes and shapes, but they have the same structure because they come from a common ancestor millions of years ago. That common ancestor had 5 finger bones. And so now all the animals that descended from that common ancestor also have 5 finger bones. Even a bat, a bat's wing has the same finger bones that we have, but they're just longer to support the wing. So this is evidence of evolution because it shows that we have a common ancestor with bats a really long time ago and with dolphins, which is why this is called "You're more like a dolphin than you think," because we have a common ancestor with dolphins. It's just from a really, really long time ago. So this is evidence of evolution. Let's go on to the next station. This one shows us the foot of a chicken and the foot of an allosaurus. And birds and dinosaurs have a common ancestor as well. They're pretty closely related, and we can see that in the similarities in their feet. So that's what you were supposed to see from this station. This station is showing you evidence of evolution because it shows you the ancestors of modern rhinos. And you can see all these ancestors, they kind of look like the modern rhino, but they have some differences. Like this one's got some longer limbs than the modern rhino, right? And it doesn't have the horn on its nose quite yet. So this shows us what rhinos used to look like. And then today they look different because of evolution. It shows that the rhinos have changed over thousands or millions of years, right? So that was station 3. Station 4 is some more practice with cladograms. So let's do just like one or two of the questions together. So question 1 says, there are two traits that apply to the wolf. Which two traits listed on the cladogram above apply to the wolf? So I'm going to figure this out by finding the wolf right here. And then if I trace the path backwards from the wolf, the first trait I hit is carnivorous, meaning it's got sharp teeth to eat meat. So the wolf has that trait. And then if I keep tracing it back, I also hit hair. So the wolf has hair as well. And then I get back far enough to hit the common ancestor of all these animals. So the two traits on this cladogram that the wolf has is carnivorous and hair. I would not trace it forward because the wolf split off before these traits evolved. So the wolf does not have the traits that are in front of it. It only has the traits behind it. Now, station 5 is some more cladogram practice. Let's do one of those together. It says, which organisms in the chart above have an amniotic egg? An amniotic egg has an extra membrane in it so it can be laid on land. But you don't need to know that to figure out this question. So all we have to do is find amniotic egg on this cladogram. It's right there. And then this is showing us when an amniotic egg evolved. So everything behind it does not have an amniotic egg, but everything in front of it does. So all we have to do is trace forwards from this trait. So from amniotic egg, I'm going to trace forward and I hit primates. I'm going to do it again. I'm going to trace forward and I hit rodents and rabbits. Trace forward again and I hit crocodiles. Trace forward again, I hit dinosaurs and birds. That means all four of these groups of animals have an amniotic egg. Okay, so that's some more cladogram practice. Station 6 also has some cladogram practice. Let's do just the first question together. It says, which of the descriptions in gray applies to cnidaria? Cnidaria are a group of animals that includes like jellyfish and stuff like that. But again, you don't need to know that to be able to answer this question. All you have to do is find cnidaria on this cladogram, which I see it right here. and we're trying to find out which of the descriptions in gray applies to them. So to do that, I'm going to start at Nidaria, trace backwards. I don't go forwards, remember? This would be forwards. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to go backwards. And I hit Eumetazoa. That's a group of organisms. So Cnidaria belong to that group. And I'm going to keep tracing backwards and I hit Metazoa. So those two groups of organisms, the Cnidaria belong to because I traced back and I hit those two groups. Okay. Now let's go on to station seven. This one is showing you embryos, which we learned about a little while ago. Embryos are a baby when it's first developing, before it even starts to look like the organism it's going to be born as. So here we have a fish embryo, a reptile, a bird, and a human embryo. They actually all look pretty similar. And because embryos of different species all look really similar, that is evidence of a common ancestor from millions of years ago. That means we're related. So humans are related to birds and reptiles and fish because our embryos look so similar. Okay, so that's evidence of evolution. It's evidence that we had a common ancestor and then evolved from that ancestor and became different, right? And the two traits that embryos have in common, all embryos pretty much have in common, are gills and a tail. So that's evidence of evolution. Let's go on to station eight. All station eight is trying to show you is like the similarities between embryos. And then once they become like a fetus, which is farther developed, then they don't look so similar anymore. So this is showing you the early development. This is showing you the middle development. Then this is showing you late development, like when you can tell what it's going to become, right? So you can see in the early development of all these species, they all look pretty similar. They look a little different, but you can't really tell what they are going to become, right? Look at this cat embryo. You probably wouldn't be able to tell that's a cat if it wasn't labeled, right? Same with the bat. I would have no idea that that was going to become a bat if I didn't see it labeled, right? Same with a human. So they're all really similar to begin with, and that is evidence of evolution. Now, later on, they start to become different. Like, look at this chicken. It actually looks a little more like a chicken now than it did before, right? So this is evidence of evolution because they all look so similar to begin with, okay? Here's our last station. Station nine is also talking about embryos. And this is showing you the same thing. It's showing you that at the beginning, they all look really similar. Here's the beginning stages. Here's the middle stages of development. And then late development, look how different they are. They become really different in late development. And then this is showing you the adult version of it, right? So remember, in early development, embryos all look really similar, and that's evidence of evolution. And they all have gill slits and a tail. Even though humans don't end up with gills at the end or with a tail when they're born, they have it to begin with because they have common ancestors with these other animals. So hopefully that was helpful. And if you were confused on the what you're more like a dolphin than you think assignment, hopefully this clarified some things for you. And send me an email if you've got any other questions. Good luck on the test, which is going to be Thursday, Friday.